everybody, and welcome once again to Danny and Son's Realtech Mod Pack. This episode, I'm going to do some environmental tech, big machines, multi-block machines. And probably, if we've got enough time, we'll do the biggest of all multi-block machines I've ever seen, which is something in the order of 18 by 4 by 3. So 3 wide and 4 high. So let's start with this one. So in the book, we have a section about environmental tech. So what we hope to do today, as well, what I hope to do anyway, is I would like to build a solar tower, and also, which is a multi-block machine. Let's have a look at this one, press like that. It's quite large. It's in the order of, well, you can see everything you need. I've got everything they need for all of the machines I want to build today, but it's a lot. Well, I'll look at my inventory in a second. We'll have a look at that. And then it needs, so the solar tower can produce steam from water or distilled water. So we need to give this distilled water. So let's have a look at doing that first of all. I'd like to put it right at the back because we need some solar towers there. So let's get on with that. I think I'll do the distiller first of all. So let's have a look at the distilled water. So we need this machine. And I'm going to use the projector for doing that. So let's get the projector into my hotbar, into here and into the book. So now, I'm going to start over here, I think. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create, first of all, yeah, you can see it now, a multi-box structure. How big is this one? It's in the order of a thing. Of course, these things are always difficult to know which way around to put them to start with. I think this is a 3x3 one. So first of all, before I do that, let's just get that here. I want to make an infinite water supply. So let's just put an infinite water supply, somewhere like this, I think. And with that, we'll just put some water in there, which I got prepared. I think I've got, I hope I've got everything I need today. But, you know, it doesn't always work that way. So I would like to put a pipe out of here into the distiller. Now, the distiller, I can put it straight into the distillery here. So we need to put the distiller down here. And I think this is the wrong way around. So let's press the middle button and rotate it. This looks like a good one, but I also think I want the redstone block on the left-hand side, like this. And that'll go out. So that'll then give me an output at the back, I hope. So let's get rid of everything in my hotbar that I can, and get the bits and pieces we need. So we need some steel scaffolding. We don't need the book. We do need the projector. We don't need the pickaxes. We'll need some iron sheet metal. Redstone block, I noticed that. I think we need some light engineering blocks and some piping, so let's get that out of the way. And where's it gone to? I know I've got plenty of pipes in here, 45 of them, yet. So let's put these down first of all. And then quickly build up this from not too close, like that. And so we just need a steel scaffolding down here now. And the block here, and then we come up here, and then we see the next one, we need another block on top of that, so then we can stand up here and we can put the sheet metal down here. Like that, and then the redstone block, and then we have another scaffolding here, one, two steel scaffolding, and then four sheet metal. Like that. And what we then do is we just hit this with a hammer. So in here I've got the hammer, I think. Yep, good. Now, which face do we hit? I think it's one of these middle blocks. It must be the middle block between maybe it's redstone engineering block. This one, I thought that, yes, that's the one. So you have to click the middle one of those. So that's then the distiller done. Let's remove this out of our helper so we can see what actually happens. So we've got an input here, and we've got outputs on the side and at the back here. So what we want to do is we want to feed the water that comes out of here into the solar tower. But before we do that, we need to also build some mirrors. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the steam down below ground, because we've probably got enough space to do this down below ground. and it needs to be 5 blocks away. So if I'm lucky, I should be able to put the solar mirrors here. Now, I can tell you, it's going to be a really big contraption, this thing. So let's get the book out. Let's go back up here and then go back to this thing here. And the next page along here, we should be able to see this. So let's just stop that and we'll see the end result. So this is a mirror. So we unstop it and then pause it. So you can see we've got all of these bits and pieces in here. So we need to build these solar reflectors. Let's go up and look at it. Let's go down and see the whole thing. So basically it's four steel scaffolding, two light engineering blocks, one block of silver. Now to make that I use this, in fact you have to, if you use the immersive engineering silver. So you can put that in the tinker smelter and then put a cast down there, a basin, and that'll cast out one of these blocks, which is great. So let's start with this one. We need four of these things, strangely enough. Well, one will do. I may just build one on camera today. So let's have a look at that. I want to put this into the projector. You can press W actually. If you hold down the shift and W, it'll flick it straight into place like that. So let's get this out of here. So now when we put this down, we should see the pattern, and I want it to go sort of like that. I think it'll do fine here. So let's just put down a block. I should put down the scaffolding block, but I'll knock it off later on. Let's put it down here like that. So you can see we need two fences to start with. So let's I'll break that scaffolding block because I'm going to need it anyway. So let's just get my pickaxe out for that and break it again so we can actually see. Because we're going to have the pipes going down there. So we need some treated wood fences. I'm actually hoping I've got enough room to do this. So what I'm going to do is jump onto this one, and then I could put this one on by jumping onto it like that. So now we need the steel scaffolding on top of that. Let's put the steel scaffolding on that one. Oh, missed it. And that one. And then we need a light engineering block. So let's just get those into place. This is getting pushed by a fly. That's funny. Flies pushing you around. I don't know. Like that. And then we have another steel fences here like this. One fence there, one fence there, and then this block of steel in the middle between those two. Oops, and I missed it. I thought I got my pickaxe. I'm going to try that again. Right, and this time we need another light engineering block here. So I'm too close this time, so I have to go back a bit. And I missed again. I'm actually not doing very well with this. Let's knock this one out of the way. And put that down, and then put this down, and that should form it. We've got one block in the way, so let's just jump down. It's a bit high, but take a little damage. So I want to get rid of this one here. I think this is the one I put down extra. So we can then right click this with a hammer. In fact, what you do is you right click the silver block here, or a block of silver here like that, and then it forms into this solar mirror. It's night time. I'm going to have a quick sleep and come straight back again, so that we can see that in daytime. Now 5 blocks away from this we can build the solar tower. So let's just measure those out. 5 blocks, whatever, got those 5 blocks. I can use this high voltage cable, and I'll use this dirt here. I've got 6 dirt, so it's got to be between 5 and 10 blocks. So I guess that means 1, 2, 3. Fast getting dirt on that. So that's 5 blocks away. So this is where we can put the solar tower. So let's get in the book and get the recipe for the solar tower going. So let's back 1-2 pages like this, and then that's the recipe. Let's just pause it and unstop it. That's the one, isn't it? So if we pause it, then we can go like this. So this is the structure. So we need the redstone block not on the side that's facing us. So if we would like the redstone block, say here, I think, so we can control it. So that's all we're going to do is now put this into the projector again. So let's get the book into the projector, put the projector down there and get the book out. So now when we look at this thing, we can see where it is. Now see where the redstone block is. I want the redstone block to be on this face, which is here. I think that's where we need it. So let's set that as a position. Okay, so what we now need to do is just put down the blocks that we need for this. So we get the three pipes out, and for I can put those directly on the dirt, of course, or maybe not, like that. So there's a, and then we can put the scaffolding. Oh, there's one more pipe goes down here. Let me think about this. I think that might be wrong, because I think we need to output steam, and I think that's the steam output. So maybe I need to move this around again. So let's do that. So shift right click this off somewhere else and put it down here. So that would mean that we would want this face to have the redstone block. Okay, no big deal. Let's just break this one away. Like that. And that should then do. Good. So now we just put this. This actually wasn't too bad as it happens. We can put that one in there, and then we can put the steel scaffolding down in the corners. Oops, missed again. Remove this one. Actually, should put the hammer out of the way so we can get the rest of the blocks that we need. As you can see, for the, this build we need 12 blocks of steel, so there's a lot of steel in this. So now what do we need? The redstone block here. And then we need some fences. Let's put the fences. We don't need any more redstone blocks for this build, do we? So that's fine. Fences go down here on the corners. And this looks like, I think this must be sheet metal. Now we'll take the pipes out of the way. We don't need those anymore. High voltage sheet metal is, here we go. There's 50 of these. That's a, also a fair amount of sheet metal, if you can see what I mean. That's that one, yeah. And then in the middle we've got a, it'll be a heavy engineering block, I'm sure of it. To get rid of the dirt, put the heavy engineering blocks down here, because I think this build all has heavy engineering blocks, as you can see. Stand up and do it that way. So it just repeats this process, so we go around again. Four, and then the fences. Difficulty in my words then, aren't I? And here we go again. What have we got again? Another heavy engineering block. And then again we have these sheet metals, as you can see. Ah yes, this is a difficult one. Put that in the wrong place. So we need to, there's nothing there, it's this level, so I have to put it against this face here like that. And that'll do that for that, no problem whatsoever. I've just fallen down a bit, so I'll go on to that one. That's right, because it has a gap. But the fences don't, we still put the fences down here like this. There we go again, another heavy engineering block. More sheet metal, fences, that's it, obviously four fences, so these must be the last of the four fences. And then we have more sheet metal, I think. Nope, what have I got in my hand here? Scaffolding. Right, green, so it's completed. So let's just get down from here. Obviously it's a bit of a drop, don't want to drop that far. So let's get the hang glider out if I haven't got it. I haven't got my hang glider with me. That's not a sensible idea. I wonder, can we get down here at all? I don't think we can, but try it. Nope, too far. At least I fell onto this bit here, so that's all right. Can break these blocks away now. Now we can tell where this is working. I think we have to hit this on the redstone block here. Yeah. Now we just move the projector out of the way and put the book down so we see it like this. So here you see the, no, I built it wrong, haven't I? Because this is the input here. I was sort of right. So we have actually two inputs. and an output. Oh, actually, that is where I want it to go out, don't I? So I want the water coming in from here. Maybe what we have to do is to have two of these. So let's right click this and redstone control inverted onto that. Let's just right click this, and you can see we've got one of these illuminated. So that's okay. So we're in range for this one. So now it needs water, and it's going to take water, or distilled water, in this side and output on the other side, that. So let's route some water out of here. So I just need some pipes to go through this. Maybe I should take this one more down. Because we want it to come, we'll do it that way, I think. So, well, I'm talking to myself, aren't I? If we go underneath the ground here, straight underneath the ground here, I'll drop it down another block. And we can come through that one, and we can come out through here. Sand. Like that. I think we should be able to do it like this. Drop that one down, drop that one down. Because it's got magnetic armor on, which helps a lot when you're doing this sort of stuff. I think I've got to go back one more block, so we can't see that block, so let's remove this dirt block here, and it should be this block here. Yeah, you can see it just got lit. And then it goes into that like that. So I'll just put the dirt back. Oops, too many. Good. So this is now piped up. This, of course, now needs some water in it, so we need to put a pump onto this, and it needs power for the pump, and it needs power for this as well. I'm not exactly sure how much power it needs. We'll have to figure this out as we go through. Now, when we put these pumps down, they always have input at the bottom by default. So what we're going to do with that is we are going to then put a lever on it. Where's my lever gone to? Like this. I'm also going to have to block off those two sides. Have I got any? I'm just wondering if I've got any slabs with me. I think I have got some slabs because I was clearing it out. My working inventory was in this one. And it might be in the builder's backpack. Let's have a look at the builder's backpack. No. Builder's backpack tends to pick up all sorts of bits and pieces. Digging backpack, mining. I think it must. I don't think it's in the adventuring one, because the adventuring one, you define yourself as to what goes into it. Anyway. So we just need some power on this, and we need to power this machine. As you can see here. Now I'm hoping that I can bring one. I should be able to do that, shouldn't I? There's cables coming round here, so let's just bring another cable across to this one. I think this will do. I don't have some fences with me. I'll go and get one of those and come straight back. Yep, I did have one with me. So let's just put this down here too. And I think I would only need to have a relay on this. So let's put it down here, like that. Get out of the bag a relay. I normally put lanterns on everything, but today I'm not going to do that. Just jump up here and get on it, which is sometimes hard, that we are. So we can then shift jump this, put that relay onto this. Then we just need a cable. These cables, yes, I'll use one of these cables like this. Cannot attach wire here. Oh, it's an MV wire cable, that's not useful. I should have spotted that, shouldn't I? It was looking a bit bigger and I was thinking, oh yeah. So let's just get the right one out of the bag then. That must have been an MV one, yes. Put that in, get an LV one. That. Put that on, so I should be able to attach the wire now. Yep, So of course I've got to take another little drop as I go down this thing. If you're very good, you can do it sort of not like that. So we can connect this wire into this, and then from here we can connect this across. So let's connect this across to this machine here. So I just need two connectors. I need another piece of wire, of course, don't I? One there and one there. We'll link it into the pump first of all, so this will start getting water if I turn the pump on. Ah, yes, one more thing I've got to do with the pump, of course, is to actually configure it to go out of the back, which I haven't done yet. So we come along here and we shift, hold it, and it says no connection, so I want it output. So now this should be getting water in it, fantastic. So this will now, not yet producing distilled water, because we need to connect this up, so we'll take another wire from the bag and connect that into this. Oh, this is already linking to something. In fact, they all are, I know that. So, like that. And then this has now got power, and you'll see it's now producing distilled water. In fact, it's actually going down surprisingly fast. I am surprised about that. I would have thought that it had enough water from one pump. No, it doesn't. So we have to then give it a second pump. Have I mess this up? Nope, it's an output. Well, I wonder how you make that go faster then. If you've only got one input and one pump on it, I would have thought that was enough. Oh, hello, zombie. Let's get rid of you. I basically also leveled this all off before there was a big hill here. So I got a lot of resources, well, dirt and stone from that. So now this should be getting into it some distilled water, it is. So now that then needs power. Now it has got no power at the moment because, and this is empty because it's night time. So let's have a quick sleep and come straight back again. So now it's got daylight and it should be producing steam. So now it's got 450 millibuckets of steam. So if you look at the uses of this, let's have a look at water. In fact, it should have told me when I was looking at the immersive engineering thing. So I've got enough space, hopefully, to put another one of those mirrors. It's got to be positioned around about here, and one on the other side, which of course is going to be a bit of a nuisance. And it's got to have a direct, no blocks in the way. How many blocks have we got? One, two, five. Maybe I can do it. I might have to remove this and push it back a bit. That's no big deal. Or move the whole tower a bit. I'll do that off camera anyway, whatever I'm going to finish with. So we need to, what I would like to do is put another mirror in front of this one. So we need five blocks away from this one. So let's just put down some dirt again. So this is where the next mirror's got to go to. Now, after I've got to change the book, of course, let's get the book open and go to the next page here. That'll do, and then put that back into, in fact, I can remember the recipe for this, and it's probably easier to do it like, just put it down. So we need one of those there, one of those, oops, missed again. We can go up on that one. So we need another one of those here, then we need two steel scaffolding. Oh, we do need that, put those down. We need one block of silver, don't need any pipes, steel scaffolding and a light mechanical. Those are the four bits we need for this. So on top of that goes steel scaffolding, in front of that goes the light engineering block. I've done all that now, put the scaffolding down here. Then it goes on to this, the block of silver, and then we need two more fences. And then we need some more scaffolding. Like that. And then the last one of those is another light engineering block. Let's get down, maybe I can jump down there without too much damage, and then right click this with the hammer. And we get the second mirror. So let's just remove this one. I need an axe for that, and I do have an axe, really good. And we'll just remove this. Then we'll just check this. So now we've got the two. So we are allowed to have one block down here, which isn't interfering with this. I think it might be just if you put one block directly in line with it. So for example, Let's just pick up those two blocks of dirt and put this on top of there and have a check of this again. It's still lit, so we're still okay. And then another one, and it's still lit, so that's still okay. Actually, that's surprising because I'd expect it. Oh no, it's got one more block to do it. Let's try again. Now that should have blocked it this time. Actually, it still says it's working. Interesting. Anyway, so it looks like we can have, maybe it takes time for that to actually come into play. So that's working. So the next thing we're going to do is put down the boiler. It's going to go down here. Well, that's it for this episode. We'll have to wait until the next episode before we actually build the machine. I'm hoping I've got enough room as it happens, because I'm not 100% sure. Anyway, I'll do some testing between now and then. So until next time, I wish you all the best. Bye for now.